Hey, it's Bill the Handyman up here in Northern California. How y'all doing today? Today we're going to talk about a Bosch dishwasher. So this is okay, the model number's over here on the side. Right there. Anyway, let's talk about the soap dispenser. If your soap dispenser is stuck, if it does not spring back on its own, then there's a problem with the spring, basically. Or there could be a problem with the plastic rail. And so basically what you need to do is you need to disassemble the front door, and if you're going to replace the whole thing, you have to disassemble the front door. If you're just going to replace the spring, you don't have to disassemble the front door. This, I'm not going to take it apart, but basically it should pull to the left and come off, and then you can access the spring. See if it's connected correctly, to see if the mount for the spring is bad. Basically, once again, you should be able to just pull to the left and this whole thing will come up, the end will come up, and then the back side here will slide in its tracks. They have some tracks. You slide, once you have this part up, you can slide this back and then pull the whole thing off and inspect the spring and the spring mounts. And so in order to replace this, once again, you have to have, this is a Torx head. You have to have the Torx head to pull the screws out of the door. Now, what happens on some of these, the writing gets worn off of these buttons. And you can see that this one here is completely worn off. This is probably, I'm going to guess, this is like the main wash cycle here. It's completely worn off. This is the regular cycle. This is the Power Scrub Plus cycle. And of course, this is the rinse and hold cycle. So let's take this out of here, and I'll show you how to do that. And once again, we have to take all the screws off along the side of the machine in order to take this top up. Okay, so once you have the wiring holder off, basically this just pushes up and it pushes through. You can see there's little clips here, here, and there that hold this piece in here. So you just have to sort of push this up above those clips and push it through. And of course, disconnect the wires, and that thing will come out of there. Okay, so sometimes this is a regular 110 wax motor. The wax motor basically activates the door, whatever, the rinse aid mechanism, and the regular detergent door. Once you get these clips pushed up, then this thing should just push through, theoretically. Coming loose, but it's still pretty tight. Let's check the top and the bottom of it. The bottom also has clips here and here you have to disengage. Okay, so we got the soap dispenser out. And so basically, once again, this door, simply if you pull it all the way over this way, this edge will come up, and then you can slightly pry and then pull these other edges off, and that will come off. And you can see how this the spring attaches here to this little knob right there. And there's a little sort of wave in the spring. The wave of the spring, of course, goes toward the outer edge of the cover when you attach it right there. And it goes this way here as seen. Basically, it will just push off that tab with a screwdriver. And so what may have happened here is one of the tabs may have broke, or it just popped off, and we just simply need to reattach the spring if your door doesn't spring back. Okay, so in order to test this wax motor, you can test this wax motor here with an ohm meter. And what I usually do is I will spray these mechanisms with a little bit of silicone, and I'll also spray the slide areas and the spring here with silicone. Just a light silicone and wipe off the excess. Now the track, I'll spray a little silicone in the track as well. So in order to test this wax motor, basically we if you have a meter, this is simply a 110 wax motor. If you put 110 volts to these two terminals here, eventually this wax motor will sort of expand and push this mechanism to activate. If you put 110 volts to those two terminals and these wax motors don't work immediately. Usually they'll take a minute or so to come out, to push out. But if you do have 110 volts and your motor doesn't push out, that means the motor is bad. Now, the other way is to test it with a meter. If you set your meter on ohms and you touch these two terminals here, you should get a continuity reading. And so we do have a continuity reading here. And so we can see how that works. Okay, so you see this one, we have all the writing worn off. So this is how this should work. It should be open when it's not in use. Should close like that, and then when you open it, push this button, it opens. Close, push the button, open. So that's your Bosch tip for today. Thanks for watching. If you need any help, you can contact me. I'm serving Northern California. Thanks for watching.